Got some doxing purple and prussian blue. Liquid Tech's heavy body. Just smaller tubes. Got some new fresh water and my trusty Maxwell House jug coffee thing. Same brush as last night. Just threw some blue and purple. Just gonna get it going. Gonna add some wash color. Start to tint our drips. Nothing special. Trying to get the edges a little bit more this time. I'll eventually cover the sides of the canvas, even though it'll probably be in a frame. I'll cover the sides of it with some black gesso. That does a really good job. Get some water. Same process as last time. I'll have to set up a little bit. It's this heavy bodied acrylic will really, really cover. And I want to see my background that I made last night through this. Heavy on the top, lighter on the bottom. Now when I hit this with the water, the dry underneath is going to show sort of through. Switching to a water bottle that has a little bit more flow. Some movement going. You can do this process over and over again. It doesn't take a lot of paint, so your supply cost is very low until you arrive at something that is a background that you want to work with in your painting. I'm really trying to help you with this glare. Trying to show you. That's what I'm looking for. You can't really see it. I'll move the camera in close in a moment. A lot of people ask me how I keep the water off the floor. And on the bottom down here, there's an old towel that I keep under this. That absorbs any moisture that falls down from the canvases. That's what I'm looking for. It's important to cover even the bottom of this with a very thin layer of the purple-blue mixture that I'm using. You can kind of get an idea of the effect we're getting. You want the paint to kind of cling to the canvas. And I'll move the camera a little closer so you can see what I'm talking about. The look that you have from the drips with your paint from underneath. Again, you can stop the process at any point. You could do it from the very first time you put color on the canvas to maybe you have an air can that you're hitting it with for an effect. A lot of people say, oh, you should have stopped. But the fact is, you can stop at any point you want. And as I'm going along, I'm looking for a composition in the future. And so I'm looking at this area, which is really dark. And I'm just going to lighten that up a tiny bit. I like this particular area up here. It's done, as far as I'm concerned. Okay, the glare is up pretty high, but you get the idea. like this, the thicker paint up in this area. I like that, and that's what I want to keep. As I look over my whole canvas, I start looking for areas that might need a little more thinning, and as I see it right now, this is pretty much where I'm going to leave it. If you wanted to keep it just like this, you can take the canvas off and lay it flat and let it dry. And then you've got a really good base for your next part of your painting, whether it be a figurative, a landscape, a narrative, I mean, a seascape, anything, because you've created a background that is diverse and different and can only be done this way. I'm going to move this light up a bit. And I'm going to close the window. And you can kind of see what I'm looking at. You get some lighter areas left here, like where you first put your water on. That's okay. You can come back a little bit later and add a little bit more purple to that, or blue, or whatever, green, or whatever you want. Earth tones work great. I keep a lot of lights in my studio for my own use, but it doesn't help with video that much. So if I cut them out, you probably see this. Okay. So what I'm going to do is let this dry. Another trick you can do before I sign off is you can flip the canvas upside down at this point, but it's going to change your look. And so once this dries, we will have a nice area, a nice canvas to work with. I'm going to do one last thing. I'm going to take the brush out of the water. I'm going to bring this color back up on top here. And just hit that one little part again. Just to give me a little more fill in the drips. Again, you can diffuse this further. I have two water bottles. This here produces large droplets. This one here is more of a spray. You can use any combination that you want. You get better at practice about the size of your drips and how it's looking, the amount of water you use. I actually don't use a lot of water, even though it looks like I am. So I'm going to let this dry now, and this will be step two, and we'll go from here because we're getting a lot of, to me, I'm seeing forest look over here, even though there's not a lot of green. There's green showing through from the back. But this almost looks like trees over here for me. And so I'm getting a real forest feel about this particular painting, or it could be underwater. So we'll see how it goes. Oh, well, sign back on and let you see it when it's dry.